Governor.
Yeah, good morning, Mr. President.
How are you getting along?
Well, we got our troubles up here with the Dominican Republic.
I've got a little problem I want to talk to you about. And ask your advice. Can you talk to Thant on a matter that the two of you would be the only two up there that would ever know it?
Well, I can certainly guarantee it as far as my office is concerned.
Yeah.
And I've always found that in cases where I've had to communicate with him in total secrecy, that I've nothing has ever happened, but I've never known whether he told anybody else or not. But there's certainly never been any leakage. And I think, therefore, my answer is yes.
All right. I know that would be true of you without asking, but I think you better feel him out and see if, in your judgment, if your prudent judgment is, you can tell him. But if you do so, make it clear that it's just the two of you, because I'm keeping it to about three here. And I don't want, I just cannot afford to be murdered on it, and I don't want anybody to know it. I'm seriously considering, and I'm going to notify our friends in Hanoi and already the Russians and some other necessary people that we got the birthday coming up out there, and we are going to stay out of the north part of the country for a while, conditioned upon their taking similar action and letting up on their actions. We're going to have a rather extended pause of several days, and we're letting them know in advance that we're going to, that if they take steps that endanger our security, well, we'll have to reconsider. If there's any indication that
this refers to the Viet Cong.
Yeah. Well, the infiltration from the north. We expect activities in the south, but if they can show us that they can hold up and it does any good, why then we can go to other steps. But we're going to take the initiative, take the first one, close down in effect on all your bombings in the north, and see what, if any, reaction they have. We don't think they'll have any. We think this is just a lot of poppycock, just like the negotiation thing's poppycock. But the Russians have been saying all along, well, if you quit your bombing, first they said that if you'd give us a policy, then we gave it to them. Then they say, well, if you'd only negotiate. Then we say, Baltimore, we negotiate. Then they say, well, if you'd only stop your bombing. So we're going to stop it. And we're going to give them a chance if they'll do anything. And that includes everybody in the world that thinks that that's the way to solve it. And then we're going to look at our whole card every day as we go along. I would like for you to know that, and I'd like for you, Thant, to know it. I don't want anybody else to know it, because the first other person that knows it, I immediately lose three-fourths of the support I got here. I get a hell of a domestic problem immediately, and I would be forced to do something I don't want to do, resume them.
I think you'll get a good reaction domestically if it doesn't go.
Well, they're all going to be raising hell why I'm doing it, and I'm not going to talk, and I'm going to just... The quad out there doesn't want to say he can't do it on account of Buddhist birthday, and I'm going to do it on account of it, except not say so. And we're just going to try to ride it through for several days and see how we get through.
Can you give me any indication of how long?
Several days.
Do you think that there's a possibility here, if you don't get any positive response from Hanoi or the other bases you touch, of using this opportunity for the, linking this up with one of the other alternatives we've discussed, and that is the Secretary General calling for discussions of the conditions of, for a cessation of hostilities in the atmosphere of a U.S. suspension?
Well, I'd be glad to go into that after we see what happens here. Now, we are notifying them. They have raised these questions with us from time to time. And we're notifying them through various tracks that we have. We've already notified the Russians direct. And we're not notifying Hanoi.
Hanoi notify Hanoi?
Well, they are and we are too.
Yeah, so that's one thing Thant can do very greatly.
Well,
is to notify Hanoi.
Well, we
that these are deliberate, waiting, indicating a willingness to talk about peace.
We're doing that right now, direct.
Direct.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And we
well,
just.
There may be a possibility, and this is all to be kept entirely quiet in the sense that there's to be no when speculation starts.
I just didn't want him or you to. To be having a press conference or be giving out a statement or saying that this or that ought to be done during this very critical period of several days. And it's already on.
There'll be press speculation about it, won't there?
Well, I hope not, but I'm sure they will. I think the first thing they'll do is go to the colonels and Da Nang and say, why didn't you bomb North Vietnam Tuesday night?
Yeah, then Hanoi may leak it too, won't
and
they?
Then,
and attack us on the ground that we're trying to buy them and that this is blackmail.
Perhaps, perhaps, perhaps. And we'll just
this
have to.
Why I was wondering if you could introduce a third element, whether it's the Pope or SYG or somebody else, to say, well, at least this ought to be an evidence of good faith and inducement to you to come into negotiations to discuss the terms of a cessation of hostilities. I think maybe there's a link here that you could make that would you could exploit more advantageously than doing this in secret and just leading public speculation as to whether this was deliberate or whether you were this was necessary for military reasons.
Well, if it gets public speculation, we can't do it. If it gets out here where they definitely identify this as what it is, we will be stopped on several grounds. First, Quat can't do it. He can't survive it. And the second thing is, I don't know what we could do in the Congress. I think if the liberals are not going to be with us anyway. They're going to be raising hell around all over the lot. And the only other support we got is very much against this kind of a move.
Well, sir, when will this start? Today?
Well, it's already, yeah.
I was going to say that I was coming down to the cabinet meeting tomorrow. And if,
that's good. You come on down.
If I talk with him today, it might be that we could think of something else to do.
That's good. Anything
to my whole idea here has been, as I told you so long ago, to try to put the cat on their back by going the full road and letting, if he calls for a ceasefire, accept it and put them in a position of either having to reject it or accept it on unsatisfactory conditions. And it may be that we can link these two up.
Very well, if he'll do that. We don't think if they have anything like this in mind. We don't think they're about to listen to it. But we think that there are enough fuzzy people in this country that really believe it, that we ought to try it to show, to be able to in our own conscience, be sure we had to try every alternative we could.
Yeah, but I had always thought it would have been better to do that by public appeal for a ceasefire.
You could if you could do it. If you had an ideal government, you had ideal situations, and you could do it with out there just folding, it would be probably a good thing, say, watching what happens a week. But since you can't do that, and you don't have that alternative open to you, we have to do it the way we're doing it and let him deny we're doing it and so on, let them know that we're not doing it and give them 4 days or 8 days or whatever days that we decide. And if they will not react to it, then come back and say, now here's what we have done.
This is the morale effect on South Vietnam.
Yes, sir, and the government. And hell, we can't even let our generals know it here. We almost have a walkout because they think it's a very tragic thing to do.
Okay, well.
So they're going to be less than a half a dozen people know that this is happening in this country.
Yes.
They told one man at the chairman, and they told the secretary, and they'll tell one or two other countries, and it'll be you two, and that's it. But I did want him to know it, if in your judgment he can keep it just to himself for several days. If he can't do it, I wouldn't tell him. Then you come down tomorrow, and you and George Ball and Mac and the rest of you can get together and explore any of these other possibilities. And
I think there's maybe something here that fits very neatly into the The alternative to a call for a ceasefire was the call for a discussion of the terms of a ceasefire.
Well, our people are fearful that we don't want to do this merely in return for a conference. We want to pull down our forces in return for their pulling down theirs, and then we go from there.
But you don't expect they're going to call off the Vietcong?
We don't think they're going to call off anything.
No.
Nobody thinks they call off anything any more than we thought they were ready to negotiate.
Then you would have a then you would resume again and then have another pause.
Then we'll meet that one when we get to it. We don't want to speculate on that. But my judgment is we'd resume again pretty strong.
Yeah.
And if they can't do it this way, well, we'll do it another way. We want to do every way in the world we can, and we're just hoping and praying that this will have some appeal to them, and they'll stop a few of their ferries for a few days. If so, we can pull in a little further, and they can pull in a little further, work ourselves out of it like we did kind of Cuba.
Okay, I'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow.
Good. Bye.